Yeah, people pray for Tina and Candace. They're on their way to Las Vegas. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Yes.
Don't hate. Hey, is that name?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Man. Little girl's trip. Rafi's on his way to Las Vegas to watch some basketball games.
All right.
They're paying him to watch basketball. Amen. And I think they're going to take the baby in a couple of weeks. So I keep y'all posted when Roth Jr. makes his appearance. Amen. Amen. That'd be 2 and 2. Two granddaughters, two grandsons. Amen. Isn't that beautiful?
That's so beautiful.
If you thought it was safe to watch fireworks.
No, sir.
It's no place safe.
No.
Amen. Pray. Wait, when you leave for your tour? You'll be here Sunday? But then right after that, you got to. Next Thursday. He flies out and has to protect Miss Hathaway for a couple of weeks. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes.
So I want to pray for him because it'll be where there are a crowd of people. You don't know what kind of food is going to show up.
Okay.
And he's very vigilant. And then this the boy looked like a demon without the women clothes.
Sure does.
But here's what I don't understand. How you in a family and folk don't know you sick? Unless you've been sick. I mean, how do you... And you should let nobody live with you talk about invasion of privacy. There is no such thing.
That's right.
Get your own spot.
Okay.
Okay. But how do you not know that you have a crazy family member? Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
You know. And my wife told me we got the upstairs air conditioner went out, so... That'll encourage her to live, right? Because it's hot as hell up there. So the technician just called. That's why she ain't here. But she said that the McCarthy family, that left a 2-year-old out his mother and dad. Because somebody's sick child, sick nephew. Your mama, you don't know your son's sick? He drawing on his face. He looks sick.
He does. He's going to dress up.
And I called her name because I didn't know she lived in, I knew she lived in something park. She didn't live in Highland Park. She lives in Hyde Park. So what's your point? You know, and as long as I'm the pastor here, we're going to always thank God that we have on Sunday what we had before because this country's dangerous. Now, what else is on the news? Because I got to be instant in season. I'm trying to cover Creflo and all this crazy stuff before we get to this. This is some deep stuff. Akron. Remember, we have a police officer at this church.
Right.
Let's start with the first part. How about stopping? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
How about just stopping?
Right.
See, I don't get on no bandwagon. And that fake attorney, dude, quit. Everybody want to be a star. We have a police officer here, right?
Right.
How about flashing lights, you stop?
That's right.
I had one stop me. And I had a gun. That's when I had a gun.
Right.
So when he showed up, I said, sir. Mm-hmm. He asked for my... Okay. I said, sir, he asked for my license. I said, sir, I have a loaded 9mm in my glove box. I'm looking at him. You understand?
Right.
Sir. And I have to go over there to get my license. You know what he said? Mm-hmm. He said, thank you so much.
Yeah,
yeah. He wasn't tripping.
No.
He said, thanks for so. I'm like, yeah.
Right. That's right, Bishop.
Here's where the game changes. So he takes off. Mm-hmm. When you fire a shot, Linda, I said that, you know, they're not going to make separate rules for black people.
No.
When you fire a shot,
right,
the whole game changes.
Yep.
We don't know if you got another one.
Right.
I don't want Brandy coming here with no flag. I'm not interested in these five kids. You fire a shot. I don't care if it's my family member. You fire a shot at Officer Dante, he got to take you out.
Right.
Oh, there was eight officers. I don't know which. Everybody got to protect themselves. You fired a shot.
Right. And they're trained.
It's not even, this is a non-issue. And then they find a gun. Then the stupid, I just got to listen. He says, well, he was not armed. He fired a shot. Game changer.
Yeah.
Period. Okay? No, I ain't no groupie. Now, if he stopped and that happened, that's murder. He fired a shot. New ball game.
Right.
Okay? You don't know if he's... So he's not armed now. Okay, that's my take on that. It's a whole new ball game.
Yep.
All right. What else? Creflo. Let me deal with that. Somebody, I gotta be current.
Yeah.
Now I handle this. This is right here. It's heavy.
Too,
yeah. I mean, I gotta be current. Creflo, if you want to make a point about your teaching was wrong, turn your jet in. Okay. It's what he said. Okay. So somebody, some relative of this person's church hit me up. And before I garnered their respect, they probably wanted to argue with me because they don't talk to me about anything else. But, you know, I won't tell you the situation, but I got their respect. You know what the respect is? Lion, bear, then Goliath. You got to leave that alone.
There it is.
So they hit me up and wanted to know how I felt about it. First of all, they sent me Creflo $8 announces a major shift in his doctrine. Well, I never followed his doctrine.
Right.
I never followed his doctrine, okay? So I said, am I up for this? And I was. Good morning. I believe his exegesis is inaccurate in this area as well as the plan of salvation. So he ain't the first thing he wrong on. Tithing taught as a New Testament law is incorrect. But as a biblical practice afforded to the descendants of Abraham is correct. The principle of tithing is revealed in the Garden of Eden. God always reserve something for himself.
Yep.
It's Garden of Eden. Okay. And just found out now, a bishop synagogue got on there and said, same thing in a different way. Come down, London. We got a new lamb seat for you. Amen. And we got to teach you how to play basketball instead of football. You be tackling folk. Yeah, you got a new lamb seat. Okay. When you're in town, you got a new lamb seat. So Bishop Sam gets there and says, no, what he said was incomplete, but we talk about a biblical principle, because you can't have it both ways. You can't go in Galatians and say, you're the seed of Abraham, you don't tithe. You're a crooked family member.
Right.
All right? And tithing was before Abraham was before Moses, right? So tithing it's a biblical principle. All right? And that's all that. But as far as his doctrine, if you really, really, he said, burn all his books and whatever, turn your jet in. It's just, I got a problem with religious people, all right? You know, because you jump on this evangelical bandwagon where anybody with sense know if a black man did what Trump did, they would already he'd already be in prison.
Yes.
If Michelle Obama did what Clarence Thomas's wife did, man, they...
Okay.
See, man, this is...
She'd be in jail, too.
That's why, you know... So my take is, that's my take. You can disagree with me. I could care less. All right? But I got to bring it up because it's a current event. Right? So, if you got caught teaching your doctrine, piggybacking on the people you wanted to be impressed to be in their realm. That's it. Other than that, it's a biblical principle. I had a person in this church who left, who tested it. I live much better than them. Folk, that's how I live. I know a lot of pastors talk about it. They don't tithe. I live by tithing and offering. I pay tithes and offering.
Yes.
Okay? Period. A biblical principle.
That's right.
All right? Not as a new, it's how you teach it. So Bishop Synagogue is nicer than me. He a church boy. He said it was incomplete. I said, I never followed Creflo's doctrine anyway. Right? Because here's what they leave off. They leave off repentance, baptism in Jesus' name for the remission of sin, and being filled with the Holy Ghost. I got people who make big money in here. Have I ever said, well, they are exempt for the Holy Ghost? Because no.
That's right.
No one is.
No one is.
Okay? No one is. And yet, this is one of the few holiness churches. Chaz had a guest here. I had Candace and Dre were already married before he was filled. Did he get filled with the Holy Ghost?
Yes.
Okay. Michael and Lucretia.
Yes.
Okay. You may not want to, because some of y'all just grew up here, but thank God for a humane church.
Amen.
I think it's an old Barlowe doctrine. A humane church. You know? Look at the blessing of Candace and Dre. Look at the blessing.
Yes.
Are you the one that girl hit that jumper on? Yep, that was you, Gardner? Brielle? Or that's your brother? She turned around, fired a jumper, hit one of y'all. All right. I got the tape, so I don't know which one it was. I don't blame you. I don't blame you for it, not wanting to own up to it. Because she turned around and fired and hit. But what a beautiful... That family represents family.
Yes.
And I want that for everybody. I want that for Evan, I want that for everybody. What a blessing. Okay? So, no, you say you're just running your mouth, all right? I ain't trying to keep you here because I don't want no hell damage on my car, right?
Okay.
So let me finish. But that's... So then he asked for scriptures. And I said, review the book of Genesis thoroughly, especially the Garden of Eden scenario, which precedes the law of Moses. The seed of Abraham scriptures are elucidating in the context of biblical principle. He said, thanks, Bishop. Then I sent him a picture of me on my brick phone saying, since you don't want to be a singer anymore, I'm asking for a transfer for your voice. And I said, I'll start with whenever I pray. I said, since you don't sing anymore, I'm calling heaven. No answer. Could it be my brick phone? I just want whenever I pray. And I ended it with that. All right, we good? Okay, that's current events. Pray for those families. Here's a new word for everybody. Kismet. K-I-S-M-E-T. Might as well learn a new word. Kismet. Kismet, which is, kismet means your fate or your destiny. Your kismet. And I want the young men on the third row. I already got one lamb here. One year. That's Gucci, too. Dang. I want on the third row, I want it to be your kismet to be a provider for your household. That's your fate. That's your destiny.
All right.
No one in the third row is going to live off a woman.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
You're going to have your own money, pocket full of money. If you got too much money, get other pockets, all right? But no woman is going to be able to look at you and say, I take care of you. You're not going to be that kind of man. You have not seen that kind of man. Huh? You're not going to be that kind of. That's your kismet, your destiny. Mm-hmm. Your fate is to be a provider and provide for your household.
All right.
right? That's your new word for today. K-I-S-M-E-T. Kismet. Your fate, your destiny is to be a provider. Mm-hmm. And that is what David was doing. We're going to try to finish it up. Like they said, this is a marathon. Just like Law and Order SVU. 2 Samuel chapter 6. I mean, I watched, ain't nothing on TV. I watched that for a whole Saturday. You ever done that before? Just watch episode after episode?
Yeah.
Oh, y'all lying. All right. All right. Pick it up at verse where he was dancing. Because there's a difference between his dancing and his leaping.
Okay.
Okay. And then we're going to tie it in to. So since I got the young men here, I got one lamb. You know, you don't want to give your last name to a young woman who doesn't have joy. Huh? You've been to school with her all through junior high and she's never smiled. Run. Sometimes if something's happened, sometimes people just don't have no personality. Okay. And your joy, your happiness, you being cheered your whole life, your mother come, you're not used to that. You're not used to that. Look at your sister. Look at Ava and Jacy act like they ain't seen each other in years. Happy. You're not used to an old down, trodden, sad all the time woman. All right? Because you go home after accomplishing something. Huh? And that's all Wade's looking for. I want to be able to get off the road. You know, Layla got her. I want to be able to get off the road and rejoice. As a protector, I got to always look around. I don't want to come home and look around. I want to come home and release the love. Front row, lamb. Release the love I have inside. But I can't come home and watch Miss Hathaway and come home with somebody. Oh, that's you again. I've been gone 2 weeks. Okay. And I'm even going to show you before, you know, here's some thunder. I may just cut it short. I'm trying to get home. But before, I'll show you that the curses in Deuteronomy. He said, I'm on because you didn't serve me with joy. That's how important joy is.
That's right. Come on.
Huh? If she can't laugh, don't put a ring on it. Because you're going to be trying to choke her out. Your kitchen will end up being, it's some bad booze. I told you I bought another pair. Your kitchen will be the octagon. Because she has no joy. Davion's here, so I can do it. And watch. That's. Either pre-COVID. You don't want that. Okay. No happiness. No dance. I ain't talking. You can't dance to the mass choir of New Jersey. No, you can't. Even y'all don't have no bones in your body. Queenie can't dance to the mass choir in New Jersey.
She'll feast.
I don't know. She'll try.
She'll try something. Yeah.
Are you hearing me? You say, what's got to do with the message? Everything.
All right.
You know what I did all day? I pulled out a 1971 yearbook. I almost brought it here. I was a sophomore. And how I took a picture in the summertime, I had a black leather jacket. Oh, that's that black leather jacket my mother bought me, and I wore it in June. So I have a picture with a black leather. That's my sophomore picture. I have a black leather coat on. But I think most of those folks, Black Ronnie back then, I think most of those folks, so it's 71, and if I'm 66, most of the folk I'm looking at, a lot of them are dead. All the teachers, I would say, probably are dead. Okay? Man, you say, what does that tie in with joy? You ain't got time to be unhappy with another human being. How about that? You don't have time.
Nope.
You don't have time to be no martyr. You don't have no time. Well, the Lord know and forget man being handcuffed to the will of another person. I'm not talking about rough spot. I don't care who you marry, you're going to have a rough spot. We have a weather that's coming, they say. Huh?
Yeah.
Well, I'm not putting my house up for sale.
Right.
Okay?
Yeah.
All right? So that's life. I'm talking about perpetual sadness. Life is too short.
Yes, okay? Sir.
Joy. Because that clock. So watch this. I'm going to tell you. So your kismet, your fate or destiny is to be a provider and to come home to meet somebody who's happy that they're with you.
That's good.
How you like that?
Like that.
Happy.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
Those of us with birthdays and a lot of candles, we don't want to see no sad lambs.
That's right.
Your daddy is a provider. He ain't trying to see you with no sad woman.
Right.
And your mama will jump on somebody. Yeah, he like, yeah, I know. Yeah, I know she. I'd say if she can fight like she dressed, somebody gonna get hurt.
All right.
Huh? All that sacrificing, private school, girl, you are all that. Huh? Home, beautiful home, Mercedes, and your son with somebody he ain't happy. Remember you told me when you was pregnant with him? I think I like you. What about her? You ain't happy enough for me. But don't touch her. Somebody stuck tonight because they got some sad booty. Jackson, you can laugh. Somebody put a knife in a bad salad. Somebody knocked off the wrong boot. I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. I can go there. I heard that my whole life.
Right. Me too.
I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. I get joy when I think about. Come on, quarter.
She got the wrong beat, though.
You got that nice little double clap. What would you say? We need to find the beat. This is a lamb with a lot of opinion. Come on now, lamb. Help this other lamb right here.
Come on.
So I'm laying the foundation so that you won't feel sorry for this wife he don't want to come home to no more.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And I'll show you where she missed an opportunity. Right? This is heavy stuff. You can't find it on the internet. If she missed the dance, she should have caught him leaping.
Okay.
It's some bad stuff. She missed the dance.
Yep.
Caught him leaping. Are y'all ready? Think Law and Order SVU Marathon.
That's good.
Pick it up at verse 12. We got the ark.
Yep.
He happy.
Right.
If she had been all that, if she'd have been Nia or Tasha, we wouldn't even have this chapter. Because they're taught at a young age, you just can't be pretty. You got to be deep. And whoever chooses you, you have to have a doctorate in that man. And you study him. And you look out for him.
Mm-hmm.
You're responsible in Hebrew for the atmosphere in at home. Okay? If he's a provider, when he step inside, that's your territory. This is joy. This is everything. Come on down, Zoe. Good. My little men. We got new lambs.
Alicia.
Come on. Yeah. Good to see Alicia. Amen. Come on down, Zoe. Watch this. She gets embarrassed. That's Zoe Barlowe. She couldn't say Barlowe. She said Barlowe. You know why? We redoing the land? Because y'all growing up.
Yes, right. That's right. Let's fill it up. Fill that seat up.
Why can't I sit where I used to sit? Mm-mm. Two words, little boys. Mm-hmm. Key word being little.
Good. Come on.
Well, don't worry, Q. I'm going to catch you off to Jerusalem. A little boy harassed my Zoe. Tried to cut her hair.
What?
Harassing her. Don't know her mama crazy. Her mama come down there.
Okay.
She know her mama crazy. Her mama quiet. Leave quiet folk alone.
Okay.
Just a little boy infatuated with her, trying to get her attention. So, got to learn how to deal with that. Because it don't stop. Okay. Right. Amen. Everybody holding their breath. All right. Well, guess what? We live and in color here. If you think I'm off topic, adults, which you know I could care less, there's a 10-year-old in South Dakota pregnant. 10 years old.
Come on, Bishop. Bring it.
Mm-hmm. This ain't dumb, apostolic.
No.
Once you start your period, which is a part of the life process.
That's it.
That is a game changer.
Yes, it is.
It's beautiful.
Yes.
Amen. It's Amen. A part of life. It's a part of growing up. As a 10-year-old in this church, you're going to know how to keep your body clean.
Yes.
Nobody should go to the women's restroom holding their nose because you a funkadelic.
Okay. All right. Teach. Cleanliness next to godliness.
Somebody got to go behind you in the bathroom with a hazmat outfit on.
They ain't goats.
Yeah.
they goats. Sheep for goats.
Nobody's got to go through that. We ain't. Nobody's got to go to the bathroom with a hazmat.
That's right.
Duct tape. Because you don't know how to clean your body. Look, can we thank God for our instructors in the church?
Amen.
Can we thank God for Candace? Can we thank God for our instructors? The lambs are going to grow up. Don't worry. You go to gym, you'll be like, who? Something dead in here. All right. Don't worry, we don't want you to grow up either, but it's happening.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, back to the Bible. All right.
Second Samuel.
Yeah, a 10-year-old pregnant, and they going to hold her to that stupid abortion law. Is that some stupid? Okay, let your daughter, your granddaughter get pregnant. Get raped.
Okay.
The dumb place.
Stupid.
Oh, dumb country. Ain't protected. Crazy mamas and their boyfriends.
Right.
Incest, perverted uncle, play brothers. And you're going to hold a 10-year-old. That baby like to kill that child. Ain't that some stupidity?
You know it. Yes, sir.
Don't even get a childhood. Okay, all
Teach
right.
Bishop, that's good. Come on.
Second Samuel, let's talk about David.
And it was told King David,
verse 12,
saying, the Lord had blessed the house of Obed-Edom and all that pertaineth unto him because of the ark of God. So David went and brought up the ark of God from the house of Obed-Edom into the city of David with
How'd he do it?
Gladness.
gladness. What did I tell Tashi when we talked about something? Tashi stood up, like, you know what? I had a blood clot. It got cleared.
That's right.
This is my God, not my mom's God, not Ariel's God, not my dad's God. This is my God,
That's
huh?
Right.
You're going to learn, if you want something out of God, do it with gladness.
Yes, sir.
Okay? To my knowledge, nobody's in Oregon watching Devin. Am I going to watch you for the rest of your life?
No, sir.
And sneaky will short, being sneaky and lying, you will cut your childhood short.
Real short.
And I don't know, and you know what? And you're going to learn because, for safety's sake, to check in. Okay? Check in means, mama, I made it to the game.
That's it.
Daddy, I made it to the game.
Yes.
Or so, if your parents are working. Okay? Kwana took care, when Lana was in Houston, Kwana took care of her sons. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, she did.
Huh? There's nothing wrong with checking in. And leave sneaky folk alone, even if they in here.
Oh, they in here.
Anybody lying? All right.
Come on now. That's good.
Okay. Gladness.
Gladness.
And trust me, you get some birthday cake, some candles, you're going to look at church differently.
Sir.
Right now, if your parent is correct, they you know, but one day you get old, ain't nobody gonna force you to go nowhere. But you're gonna have enough life experience where you're gonna look forward to coming. You're gonna, I need to come to the house of God, huh? I tell you right now, even where you at, all it takes is somebody your age to get sick. Get sick. Or did we bury, what's that girl? Amber Harris?
Yes.
Get kidnapped.
Yes.
Stuff happens in life. You need to learn how to praise God on your own.
Yes.
You need to know how to go to God. Lord, touch my grandmother. Lord, touch my, you know what I get up every day? Lord, protect my seed. Did an 8-year-old girl get killed?
Yes.
Watching fireworks?
Yes.
From some maniac?
Yep.
Every morning, protect my seed.
Amen.
My Zoe, my Vivian, my CJ, my Rafi Jr. who ain't even here.
Protect my seed.
Okay. With gladness. And that's the parent's responsibility. If the parent don't want to come to church, the child don't want. We don't need no mass shooting to come here with no gladness. We don't need no car accident. We don't need no sickness. We don't need nothing. I don't need none of that.
Right.
Okay. Read.
And
I'm trying to bring it down on their level, okay?
You do good. And it was so that when they that bear the ark of the Lord had gone 6 paces, he sacrificed oxen and fatlings.
He's happy because nobody died because they handled it wrong.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You're going to learn you don't handle God's business any kind of way. Okay? He's happy. He's a happy man.
Amen.
He didn't have a happy woman, no. Read.
And David danced before the Lord with all his might. And David was girded.
There is a picture of Candace's wedding, and some of y'all were just dancing.
Oh, yeah.
All over this place. Just dancing and doing. Yes, you.
Yes.
Just dancing and dancing and just hopping and dancing and doing all kind of dance on one leg. Then you put it on the other leg and you was bouncing all around. There ain't nothing wrong with that.
Right.
Amen. They were what? Happy. Don't marry nobody. Now, when I say if they can't dance, everybody don't have that, all right? No, don't marry anyone who does not want to dance. Let's try that.
That's right.
Man, if you hold everybody to a Darnetta standard, then that man, ain't nobody getting up. Ain't nobody getting up. All Linda's sons can dance. Ain't that crazy?
Wow.
Now you jealous, folks. That Davion is a...
That Davion.
Ain't got a... Bone. And we won't even talk about his wife. I'm waiting for her to get pregnant again. I'm still going to challenge her. I saw her at the anniversary. Uh-huh. No, don't be calling me out. I ain't dancing with you. I ain't getting no L. I'm too old to have an L. No. When I see those twins in your stomach, I'm going to call you then. I'm going to call you right when you dilate at about an 8. Then I'm going to say, now what you got?
That's
where you at? Oh, other than that, I seen you at the anniversary. I'm like, it don't stop. Which is why I want them teaching Sunday school. I don't want no boring people teaching y'all.
Right.
Jealous of y'all.
Yeah.
Are these two lambs in your they've been playing hooky because they like to come in my office. They think they slick. But we be having class in there. And I understand. But lambs, you got to go back to class, all right?
Yeah.
I don't want no boring people teaching our kids wrong.
That's right.
Huh? There's nothing wrong, with a young lady saying, you know what? I want somebody like my teacher. He's happy. He's fun. He's serious when it's time to be serious. Other than that, man, you're going to find out when you get old, it's time to have fun.
That's right.
Serious will catch up with. How many of y'all know that?
Yeah.
Now you're kind of late.
Yeah.
That's why I don't deal with nobody deep and mysterious. If you listen to me and Pastor Linda talking on the phone, you'll think neither one of us saved. We tried, at least I do. I won't speak for her. I try to be spiritual. It don't take long, no. Because we're about some fun. And I need fun teachers.
Jesus, son.
They didn't teach you how to have fun in no church of God in Christ. Man, you was too fly anyway. That's why you left. Do y'all understand what we have here? Fun.
Yes, huh?
Can you imagine? Some of y'all was grilling. And can't cook, but you was grilling anyway. You put some fire to something. Could you imagine going to be invited over a 4-4 or whatever, and I come and I pull out my Bible? I come out in a robe.
I hold my finger and say, excuse me.
See, you know, oh, ain't that some crazy stuff? Have you noticed those folks? Those folk that visit Grace don't stay. I kill them before they come in. Like, all right, who he? We about having fun. Y'all know that?
That's right.
We about some laughter. We about you having some joy.
Yes, sir.
You don't have to be in sin to enjoy life.
Come on, Bishop.
Period.
Yes, Lord. Say that.
Sin is dangerous.
Yes, it is.
And it'll cost you your childhood. A lot of dudes when I grew up who was all that, ripping and running, messing over all the women, are dead. I just pulled a yearbook out. They are dead. Not injured, dead. They didn't even make it to 65.
Yes.
That clock gonna tick on you, okay? So David had joy. Read.
And David and all the house of Israel brought up the ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet.
So you need CJ joy. CJ was trying to play ping pong, even though his head is right there where the table starts.
Way to go, baby.
And then he misinterpreted. He thought when we hit the ball and he picked it up that he won. So I get this text that he won. He went home talking about he won. He beat Papa. You know, you didn't. All you did was he thought picking the ball up was winning. That ain't no bad attitude.
No. You wanted to win.
He missed the ball. He picked it up like, I won. No, you didn't. Huh? Well, watch it. I'm going to switch it. But hang on to that.
That's right.
I think I won. And since I think I won, I won.
That's right.
Huh? I think I won.
I think therefore I am.
That person who did all that shooting was a loser. And they've been losing a long time.
Yes.
You can lose so for such a long time. You want other folk to lose.
Yes.
So I use CJ and I segue into, you better keep some childhood joy. When you really get grown. Okay? Mm-hmm. I think I might even play a song. Anyway, it's not the mass choir. That I hope, Lambs, your husband feels about you.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Matter of fact, if you come home and you playing a mass choir, you must be unhappy. Because the Lord ain't coming back quicker because you made a bad choice. You can have all the spiritual songs you want. He ain't coming back quicker. David was happy. He danced before the Lord. Is that what it says?
Yes.
How did he dance? With all his what?
Might.
Okay, now, right, this is heavy stuff. Now, I can deal with the kids. I'll be back to y'all. Hang in there. Don't go to sleep, Tasha. I'll be back. He danced with all his might outside the city. And this was an opportunity, Erica, for old girl, bitter beer face, to come out of her emotions and join him. If the priest is there, he's a provider, you dance with him.
That's right.
If you'd had an argument, but the priest is a provider, you're taught now before you even have anybody. If he's happy, we can deal with that later. He might be unhappy because it's not happening. Men don't have the patience. If men birth babies, wouldn't nobody be here. Women know how to wait for something to come 9 months later. Men don't know how to wait. So you can misinterpret his mood. He just don't know how to wait. That's some good teaching.
Okay.
You don't want no happy broke man.
No.
Oh, the lights are out. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, the water's cut off. Thank you, Lord. The lemonade is hot. Oh, that's all right. Let's pray, put hands on the lemonade. Because the refrigerator's off. You don't want no happy, broke man.
That's right.
Okay? If he rejoices, you rejoice.
Yes.
Now, I don't know what dances is. You have to help me, but this is a rabbi. He looked like he getting down. I think I'll go to him for instruction. Look at here. What's that? You don't know what the dance is? Don't be laughing. You can't even see. Back to you. That's a. See, they don't know how deep this man is. This man probably speaks about 8 languages. But look at, he dancing.
Yeah.
That's something Papa can do. Look at that dance. Man, forget you, Tasha. Make sure you don't tumble down the aisle when you get married. This man, look at that rabbi. Oh, yeah, they be getting down. The rabbi getting down. Boy, if he drop it like it hot, that'd mess you up, wouldn't it? No, because that's the part. They're not stupid like religious people talking about we don't dance. What's that little thing y'all do holding on to stuff?
Okay. Right. Crossing your feet.
So what do you mean? There's no music here, but you need to have some music inside of you.
Yes.
I'm just going to throw it out there. Don't marry nobody don't like music. I ain't talking about those crazy, crazy lyrics. Okay? You got to have fun. Don't worry. One day you're going to be like, this is what he was talking about. Because you're going to have every reason in the world to be sad. Because that's life.
That's life.
And you're going to snap out of it.
Yes.
Huh? Can I talk to him? You're going to snap him out of it. Amen. Huh? By being free and fun. Oh, man. We don't. Even though you might have shed a tear, man, I'm going to be fun because I don't want the leader of this home to be sad. Ain't no telling what he going to do. Huh?
Right.
If you don't have no personality, save your money and get one. Buy one. Check Amazon. Rent one. David danced before the Lord. I watched the video of y'all playing. Y'all weren't out there sad. You know, y'all was missing shots. Jackson, everybody can't play like you. Missing shot, traveling. What kind of laws y'all got? Y'all gonna make me come over there and play. Y'all can play like that. Y'all walking with the ball and stuff. Huh? But they were having fun. You need to have more fun than you have sad days.
Amen.
Trying to tell you, don't worry, this will catch up with you. I understand. He danced before the Lord with all his might, and David was girded with a linen ephod. Okay, that's heavy stuff. Mm-hmm. Read.
So David and all the house of Israel brought up the ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet.
With earth, wind, and fire's percussion. Group. Now all the babies are going off today. Come on, holler. Verse 16. Holland Q, who's next? Verse 16.
And as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David.
Look at his wife.
Michal. Mm-hmm. Saul's daughter.
Look at her. You don't want no woman who is sad that you're happy.
Right. Oh, my God.
I watch you grow up. I mean, you know, I watch your mother do it by herself. You don't need no sadness, bro. You don't need somebody sad. First of all, your mama different. She ain't going to take that. Okay? You know? You don't want no sad, unhappy, moody, no personality woman. Mm-hmm. You don't want to come home to that. Your home is supposed to be a sanctuary. When I'm home, I hide cookies from people I love until they find me. And if I learn to love popsicles, you in trouble because I'm going to hide them. I'm going to have me a freezer. I ain't no popsicle person. I have a problem with sharing, and so you have other problems too. So you pray for me, I pray for you.
Okay.
All right. But I like being home. Okay. I'm going to teach you the value of your own room. See, you wanted a little brother. Now you got one. Your own room. You know, it's beautiful for your kid to have their own room. Some people will take it, and they have their own house. Privacy.
Yes.
Your own room. You missed that. She said, I sure do. My own room. A place where I can be. You got a man cave. Ain't made payment the first. A man cave.
Go ahead, Kobe.
A man cave. Ain't made payment the first. You have your own room? Look, man, that's grown men. They don't know, do they? Grown men don't have their own room. That's why we encourage home ownership. Hmm? If you have an apartment, I've lived in an apartment. You got people upstairs, downstairs, shutting the door. Get your own. Okay? That's a part of you feeling good about yourself. I own this. Am I teaching them right?
Yeah.
I own this. I always had my own room. When I went to the service, I thought I was being mistreated. I ain't never lived with that many people. You gotta be kidding. Even now, as my wife, I love square footage. She tried to share my chair. Brenda, I gave it to your sister. She said she wants to sleep in my chair. Go ahead, because you know it was hot as hell upstairs because the air conditioner, that one went out. I went upstairs like, you know, I like heat. I just don't like being cold. Heat don't bother me. Lo and behold, guess who coming up the stairs? Guess what you get for lusting after my chair? Found out I couldn't sleep in it. But she'll tell you right now, we have our house is sectioned off. I'm a liar. Ask him. It is sectioned off. Let me talk about my wing.
Yeah.
I do. My downstairs wing, I have a sunk-in tub in the floor. Uh-huh. A shower. Too tall. I got a whole wing. I got a whole office. It's just nice, people. Mm-hmm. My whole wing of the house. You go upstairs, I got the whole Jack and Jill. I got the black leather jacket room. Every jacket is both. It's nice. I ain't even thinking about y'all now. I'm disgusting. The middle part we negotiate based on she thinks that's hers, but it ain't. And there's a TV on the wall in the middle part, and the other side there's another TV on her wall. She got the whole master. She got laid out master now. She got stupid. Just it laid out. But her closet space ain't enough for me. And I got a few coats I done slipped in there. But she got the whole master. So I negotiated, folks. And then we try to have a mutual place in the middle. But if I come upstairs, you're like, what you doing in my spot? Like, nah. I wouldn't know how to act without my own stuff. Mm-hmm. What your mother's doing, you're going to find out. That man cave is setting you up for the future. That you'll never be jealous of what another man had because you grew up with your own. That's good teaching. The man cave. Huh? Got to duplicate. So David wants to come home. He celebrates with the other people. She missed out on the celebration. She was dancing. And the reason why he danced was because he was dancing to the Lord. Because now this is over y'all's head. But he was thinking about prophecy. So outside the city, he danced, huh? Because he was thinking about prophecy. What is God saying? What's he going to do next? So anytime you do too much thinking, too much thinking causes you to have to lessen your celebration. Haven't y'all thought yourself into a tizzy? How about that? When you could have been celebrating.
Yeah.
Why? Let me steal this from Bishop J. Why should you celebrate July the 5th? Because the 6th belongs to God. Right. Tomorrow belongs to God.
Yes, it does.
Okay. Now, let me switch off of y'all. People that are going to get married in the future. Remember, tomorrow belongs to God. But what about this? They're on the job. They said they're going to do this. And they having cutbacks. And boo, 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 boo. Huh? Tomorrow belongs to God. But you and I are going to celebrate today because this is the day the Lord has made. We're going to We're going to be sad.
Rejoice.
Rejoice and be what?
Glad.
Be glad. Because if you keep worrying about a tomorrow that belongs to God, you're going to the hospital.
Yes, you are.
Okay. Tomorrow belongs to God. Right? So David comes in, and this lady ain't happy.
No, she's not.
She's looking through the window.
Yep.
So this might be over your head. It may not. Don't act like you're a happy person because the little boy's happy when you're a sad person. That's called defraud. Defraud means you really are not that way. Be what you are. Okay. I'm acting like I'm happy, but you're not a happy person. No, we try to teach you how to be a happy person. Why? Watch this. I'm messing with. Why shouldn't you be happy? Because you can do this. You can see. You can smell. You're here. You have mobility. You have athletic ability. You have everything. You have all. Nobody walked in here with an oxygen machine. Nobody. Nobody. That's you right. Have a right to be happy over simple things. All right. Huh? You have your own room. Everybody gone. Look, she smiled. Everybody, you have your own room. You had your own room. You have your own room. Your place laid out. That's good. She got her own library. Huh? So only thing about having your own room, own house, if there's sadness in there, if there's a cloud of sadness, it's your fault. Because you don't have anyone else. Huh? All right? If your house is sad, if you go to the Barlowe house right now, and there's a cloud of sadness, can you imagine CJ running there? Where's Papa? He depressed. That's crazy.
Yeah.
He ain't seen no depressed Papa. That's crazy. I checked somebody. They took it and came back with a dialogue. I didn't even answer because when I check you, I'm done with it. You don't sit there and go off on your kids because you got problems. Just leave it at, yes, sir. I'm not into you like that.
That's right.
You bring me some dialogue. I ain't even read because I'm not in. If I tell you to correct something, I'm done with it. I got too many other things to do.
Right.
I don't just be shooting and picking on folk. You quit going off on your kids because you sad and picking them apart. Huh? You got to build them up before they get out in that world. Seventh grade is different than eighth grade is different than seventh grade. Yeah. High school is different. College, nobody has any rules. You can't be picked apart. You can't already go to school with a problem. You can't be bullied at home and then go to school and get bullied. You got to go out that door thinking, man, I'm going to excel.
Right.
I'm going there to excel, to learn, make friends,
Yeah. Be
my own person. Mm-hmm. Not you already beaten down. You ain't even got on the bus yet. Those are the kids who end up being bullies in your school.
Sure do.
They've already beat down. Ain't no, yep. You can't be no bully and be no happy person. You want to act out on someone else what was done to you.
Yes.
So as an adult, you don't take it out on your son. Now here's what she does. When things come up, we tell her how to handle stuff.
Right.
Because you're getting ready for a husband.
Right.
Period. Huh? We got other people that come in.
Yeah.
Watch this. I'm going to get everybody. And the longer you stay by yourself, it's hard to let go of those reins. Somebody going to come in and switch the TV. Now, I've been married 45 years. You know, I didn't like her sitting in my chair that she lusted after. Do you know how enthused I was when she said, it don't sit comfortable? Good, I'm going to get another one. All right, studying, y'all. I ain't trying to impress y'all. If she says she like it, we got a problem. Now, I got to go and sit in the chair. I go sit in there, and she all laid up in there. Now, I ain't trying to have that, okay? So the best news I heard all day was my chair. It's the same chair y'all bought. Your husband tell you? It's the same chair. Yeah, those chairs you got. How about a grand? I got that one. Because when it came to my house, he put it together like in 2 seconds. He said, I got the same chair. I'm so glad she said that it was uncomfortable. Hallelujah. Did you try to sit in my chair one time and I sat on you, right? Get out of Papa's chair. So you got bad memory. CJ came to the house. I had to unplug the chair because he wanted to play with it. He think it's a portable slide. So one time I said, he can't break my new chair. I just unplugged it and it wouldn't move. I like my own stuff. David's wife saw him and she looked through a window. So she had no excuse. And saw the king David. Now he's leaping and dancing. What's the difference? He dances, Vicky, outside the city. If he gets in the city, he starts leaping and dancing. So watch this now. leaping and dancing is better than just dancing. Why? Because when he was dancing, he was waiting on a prophecy. But when you leap and you dance, you're doing that under God. You don't matter if God ain't saying nothing. I'm doing it under you. I'm so glad I'm home. I'm so glad I got joy. I'm so glad you worked it out. I'm so glad you healed my body. I'm so glad I'm in favor. Huh? Man, can you come home with all those evil devils and spirits and leap and dance? It's good to be home. Man, if you can't go home, you can't go nowhere.
Okay.
Every one day you're going to have your own home. Tell them, grown folk, to pull up in your driveway. I won't mess with somebody. Y'all care? This is my music. I know you don't like my music. I'm playing it for London. Get off my phone. See, I was going to dedicate a song to you. I'm moving on to the next one. Remember, you ain't the only lamb on the front row.
That's right.
See, you're going to be so happy. Can you imagine your husband coming home and hearing you dancing or stumbling in your case? That was confidential. I just told the whole church.
Stumbling.
Can you imagine? Why don't my phone act right? Shut up. Yeah, I need Davion. You're missing your cue. Davion, you're missing your cue. He comes home. I'm going to talk to you. I'm giving you another chance to repent. And you can cook. Give me some volume, KT.
Give a step closer. And all that I want you, I can tell by your eyes that you want me to.
He comes home. And this is what you listen to.
Do we be together and that you be mine? I want you here forever. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Uh-oh, it's your little ankle move. Come on. Come on. Hey.
I know what I want, and baby, it's you.
Hey, I'm about to cross it up. Hold on. Watch it, watch it.
Dreams can come true.
Come on.
Look at me, babe, I'm
a fan.
You know you got to have hope. You know you got to be strong.
Hey. Is that a happy woman? Give me some volume, KT. Come on, DJ. There you go.
Here
I'm talking. Was that telling me about your dream?
Dreams can come true. Look at me, babe, I'm in the mood. You know you got to have hope. You know you got to be strong. Dreams can come true. Look at me, babe, I'm in the mood. You know you got to have hope. You know you got to be strong.
Dance before. Come on, Neil. Come on, throw that discus. London? I seen that ankle. Come on, Troy.
Dreams can come true. Look at me, babe.
that, Jackson. Hey, you got a little bobbing weave in you. Go on, Lana. You don't care. You know ability. You notice who I didn't call on? Darnett and Queenie. I ain't fear to be feeling bad. I left her right there in the back. Now, Bree, are you kidding? They'll make us all feel bad.
Yeah.
Those are machines.
Huh?
Now, you may not understand. You're like, he's corny. They know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
You know what the best day to dance like that? On a rainy day and a stormy day. You can't control that, but you can control the atmosphere in your house. Don't ever forget that.
Right.
On a stormy, right, huh?
That's good, baby.
Now, if you end up, and don't listen, because I can't do nothing about that, with Mr. Dove, what's that music? What you, turn that off. Oh, yeah, he out there. Because his mama wasn't happy. No happiness was in his home. So now you getting on this nerve. Don't marry nobody. Don't take the last name of somebody where your joy gets on their nerves. How many of y'all know one day they're going to remember the front row and being a lamb? And we talking about a short period of time. Yours is the shortest. No, yours is. Did you see Brandy sit down there? She would have stayed the whole service. Because when you got five kids, no time to yourself, whatever, to sit on the front row and be there, have no bills in your name, amen, you got your own room, man, that's a good life. Can we help them, adults? Hang on to that life as long as you can. Let everybody else be sneaky, lie, whatever. You get, stay on. Because you're blinking, it's over with. Everybody I looked at today, because remember, I was a sophomore. When I was a sophomore, I had to be like 13. Because I was a senior, I was 16 and 17. All those folk, most of those folk are not even here anymore. Okay? That time, that clock. So David got this dull lady who's mad because he's happy. Mm-hmm. So really, I went in reverse. Even though she missed the dancing and leaping, if he would have came home and heard some happy music. Keep some happy music in your house.
Amen.
Period. Keep some happy music for you. When things don't go right, get you a happy song. I'm going to train y'all. Hey, get you a happy song. Get your Ralston cheerleading outfit back on. That little girl don't need to have no degree in what you've been through. Have your song. Get your man. Where's your happy song?
Yeah.
For you.
Right.
That makes you feel good. Then your test is when you get some aid, you make sure you play your happy song around the person who thinks they want you. And you catch, you have to learn, this is a, you catch their first response. If his response is, remember, that's your happy song. After you get him straight, that has nothing to do with you. That's me. That's everything I've been through. That's going through school. That's failing tests and taking the test over and succeeding. That's being on the honor roll. That's dealing with people in school who are jealous of me, who don't like me over stuff, whatever. I have my own happy song. I refuse to go to school and let some people I didn't wake up with take me down. Has nothing to do with you. But I'm glad you didn't like it. My pastor taught me to watch your first amen. I'm too happy for you. Can I raise a daughter? Like, hold on, pull over. What's wrong? I got a dance coming on. Not no church dance. I just feel like dropping it while it's hot. Amen. I just feel like I got joy. Why? I just made the honor roll. I just made it through school. I'm a mother now, huh? I want my Echo to show Olive joy. Don't even let her that other stuff. Joy. Mommy's happy. Joy. If you're going to be sad, close the door. Wait till she sleep. Other than that, happy, happy, happy. Amen. Ain't nobody going to pick off my Olive. That's the only thing that ever came out my womb. She ain't going through what I've been through. She ain't cut like me. She ain't going to be no second baseman. She ain't going to sit there. Oh, praise him, Echo. Hey, man, I'm not letting my daughter go through what I've been through. And I'm going to be here for, I'm not going to lose my mind. I'm not going to quit. I'm not going to compete. Amen. You're right. Amen. I'll talk to you, but I'm not dealing with no nonsense when it don't concern you. Don't no dude who ain't paying no child support want to talk to me? Man, I'll hurt your feel. I'll break you in half. I'll hit you with a bullet didn't hit you. You're right. You know what I was doing. You know, nonsense. I'm not that cat. Man, I'm team Echo and Olive. That's my.
That's right.
You want me to go get a jacket?
Yeah.
I don't deal with raggedy lap-legging men. I'm not your mama. I ain't got no third breast. Taking care of your family. You want to talk to me? Man, I got Kenny sacrificing. Cammy going to get another job. Amen. Man, you want no raggedy dude? You want to put me on three-way? No, you don't. No, you don't either. That's nonsense. You make a family, you take care of them.
That's it.
That's a no-brainer. If you move on, move on. Matter of fact, when you heal, you want them to move on. You don't build no monument to incompetence, instability. That's how you set your daughter up to make the same mistake. Oh, it's just what we do. No, it isn't.
That's right.
You know what? I'm going to keep. This is so deep. I ain't going to rest through this. I only got one scripture left.
That's right.
No. Where your happy song?
That's right.
Where your bubble bath? Where your oils? Where is your feel good for you? You are not the pincushion of the world. Where your, when I sit here, I should be smelling your signature. Hey, your fragrance may not be expensive as mine, but I should be smelling your signature perfume. Ralphie went to my place and I gave him that stuff I gave your son. That's grown men. That's NBA ball play. Somebody gifted it to me. But watch this. I'm going to teach y'all a little something. I'm going to go home because I'm tired of looking at y'all. It's just like that. Because I've been talking to folk all day. You know, it didn't mix with my chemistry. Just because it was expensive, it has to mix with your chemistry. Okay? Expensive on me. So that stuff is, golly, that stuff I gave him. That little bottle, like $250. That's something from Neiman Marcus. They gave me the whole set. I gave him the whole set, didn't I? The whole set. That's grown folk. People in the NBA wear that stuff. But like, it didn't hit my chemistry. Now, my stuff ain't cheap. So Robbie goes to Chicago. He's like, Daddy, what do you pay for that stuff? I'm like, yeah, it's like about 180 euros in Europe. Matter of fact, they don't hardly sell it here. So I go to Paris just for that. And you know, TSA thought they was going to take it. I'm like, no, you ain't. I'll repack. You ain't throwing my bottle out. And it came, you get 3.4 ounces, right? My bottle's 3.3. See, they even made that for me. Y'all didn't get that. It's too bad. Now, you ain't taking that. So where's your signature? I'm talking to kids, but I'm talking to adults too. The world is in free fall. They shooting everywhere. You can't go to no public. You better find you some joy. If you can't find no joy in your house, amen, because you got to get out in that world. You ain't going to be afraid. You ain't going to stay in. I got people in Las Vegas. I got people going to go to Jamaica. Amen. You got pilots. You got people at the airport tripping. People tripping everywhere.
Yeah, they trip.
Where is your insulated joy? Where are you insulated with your own joy? I watch people watch me in traffic have joy. It just burns people up. And you know, I'm a smarter. I said, I didn't tell you to buy that car. You had no business buying that car if you weren't going to be happy in it. And why ain't your music loud? If you don't like my music, I didn't buy it for you. I bought it for me. I found how to use Bluetooth and the rest is history. Help me, Trey. Come on, Trey. Come on. Come on. Build me up, Trey. Pray.
Daddy set it up.
All right, Bishop.
Man, I'm good.
Yep.
Huh? Every day. My wife said, you an old dude. Why you take nap? Because I'm up when you snoring. I have to answer. People watch me. I'm not every single day.
Yeah.
I text her at 4 a.m. She answer right away, like she get up to. But I do. I insulate myself. Plus, I'm running out of time. I don't know how many more July 5th I'm gonna get. You the one that got unlimited access. I don't know. You tripping? Huh? That's how I live every day. I live my life like that.
Come on.
I have a window. I open the window up and I take a deep, fresh breath of air. Lord, I thank you.
Yes.
I ain't talking about, huh? Can I help y'all before I go home? Y'all let too many strangers in. And you not, that's what insulation is in your house, right? Insulation is to keep whatever you want out and whatever you want in. Where your sound? Where you? I might be playing that all week. Same song. Like literally, repeat. If my car don't have a repeat button, I'm hurt. I gotta find out where that repeat is. All day, cause I got a video mine all day. And I've won every versus battle. Every one of them. I sit them down. I'm in the booth with my microphone. In the booth. Man, I'll be hurt. I ain't ready.
Like Ronnie the man.
And I got my brick phone too. Go get my brick phone, Kitty, on my dad. You thought making fun of my Apple 6 would make me go get an 8. I said you thought making fun of my 6 would make me go get an 8.
You got a brick.
I went got a brick. I'll take it all the way back before you was born.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey. Can I teach them real quick? In my own world.
Yeah.
I just stepped out to teach y'all tonight. Other than that, when I get back in my car, it's on and popping. You know how I feel about Thursdays.
Heck yeah. Today, Wednesday.
She knows. She be like, oh, it's Thursday. Man, when it get Thursday. Tomorrow?
Today is Tuesday.
But when? You know what? Tomorrow. You better say amen quick and fast.
Amen.
Look at it. They thought I was going to get rid of, and I got me a brick. You ain't never seen that, have you, Zoe? Look at Zoe.
Does it work?
That ain't necessary. I got so much self-esteem. Did you think my phone don't even work? I ain't studying you. You thought you can't talk me into getting an 8.
Come on, Bishop. Do your
jumping up 13. I ain't upgrading nothing.
Talking about I'm black and I'm proud. I got a six and I'm proud. Now what you going to do about it? I'm not in your world.
Right.
I'm in my world.
I know that's right.
Y'all don't know how to, y'all don't know how to do that. They really know how to do that. I got books. They be trying to do what? And that's how you become miserable. That's how you look in the mirror and you see 12 other folk, but you'll never see yourself. That's how you get pulled into stuff. My daughter had a slight accident on her bike because it was raining, whatever. I didn't go, oh, don't ride. Oh, no. Okay, your helmet, no. Once your helmet hit like that, it ain't no good. I said, what? I walked by and I said, what? Get a new bike. New helmet. Queenie out there riding, was riding, practicing.
Yeah.
Because she swears she's going to be in Rwanda on a scooty. On a scooty. No, I'm not telling everybody to go get a bike. All right? I'm telling. But every bikes, yes. Cars, flying, walking, going to the 4th of July picnic is. I'm not raising people who are scared to come out. Because you can be religious and be a dull, unhappy person. You travel. You feel free. You smile. If you do not exercise those muscles and smile, sorrow is going to land in your body somewhere. And the older you get, the more access sorrow has to certain parts of your body.
Come on now.
Laugh at your own jokes.
Yes.
Sing your song if you can't sing like Coco. Yes. Sing in the shower. Find a garage. Find a place. Dance. Be happy. Get you a bowl of cereal and eat cereal in the bed. Get a popsicle and go sit in there. Come on. Find you a happy place. Danielle, you should wait till everybody get sleep. You're going to get that pool. Heat that pool up and be out there, just out there chilling.
Naked.
That's a good life, folk. What y'all think a good life is? Going to a holy convocation? 12 people in one room stacked up like pancakes?
Big Dr. Seuss hat.
Big doctor. And we ain't talking about no YSL either. We ain't talking about no YSL either. You want to know why folk are miserable? That happy song that was in 1993, the girl had one hit wonder, I Thought About You. We ain't talking about you fake happy. That go along with that fake laugh. Somebody gonna not listen, and they gonna have somebody hear, Bishop, guess what I messed up with? I said, but what's wrong with her? She laughing, Bishop. Oh, man. Oh, man, you done messed up.
Yeah, David, you gotta do it.
Echo, my mother made a man, they called him Deacon Dad. I didn't call him that. He thought it was a sin to smile. No, you know why he didn't laugh? No, I can't make fun of him. He's dead.
Yeah. Go ahead.
No, that's the man she went to school didn't have no teeth gonna run out in the car. When you ain't got no teeth, you ease out slowly. Come on, Davey. You didn't hear that in Boston. You ain't got no business blasting out. You got all these broken windows. and Dad wouldn't smile. No, he wasn't. My mother got tired of that mess. She was used to traveling. He tried to hold her up in the hood. No, she left the hood years ago. You know what she did, Chris? Went and got her own place. You know what he did? Tagged along. You ain't taking me backwards. 4'11". He was following her. That's real. That's who I. Where's your ladies? Where's your fragrance? You don't take your cues from Cardi and Megan and all them. They trifling.
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
They trifling.
Yep.
All right. Where's your fragrance? Where's your oils? Your bath? Where's your book? You got to leave that Dr. Seuss alone. All right, you got to come up. You know, I'll finish up tomorrow. And you say, you out of the Bible. No, I'm not. This man ran into an unhappy woman. I done just taught you. Happy music. 5 years from now, it's a whole new lamb group where you're happy. You fool around, you'll come to church on Thursday. Like, who is the church? You sitting in a lamb seat, but you ain't a lamb no more. They think I'm playing. See how I switch gears on them? You on a Thursday. See, you don't see yourself sitting there crying because you tested it. We talking about less than 5 years. You tested it. Got a baby by Mr. Sneaky, little Sneak Jr. Man, I'm in rare form, man. Sneak Jr. And you come on Thursday. Can somebody let me in? They have no clue, do they? Can somebody let me in? I remember sitting here. With a future, could have went to school, could have started a business, could have traveled the world, could have went to visit Nandi in Rwanda. Now you all stuck, watch this, with somebody you scared of. You bet not be happy. Who wakes up hollering at you, calling you out your name, dropping F-bombs. You'll be sitting here on a Thursday. I wish I was just a lamb. Okay? Just like that. Some ungrateful. You don't see yourself pulling up to the job crying. I want to quit, but I was taught to take care of. But I don't even want to go home. You don't see yourself putting in for overtime because I don't want to go home. How many of y'all have been in traffic and seen people staring off into space?
Gone. That's real.
Janelle, it'd be like, you know what?
Gone.
Gone.
In a suit and everything.
Don't matter. Gone. Zombies. I ain't got nothing to go home. You know, it's they're going home because of the traffic. What are you doing looking like a zombie going to your, we call it a minor, but it's really your major sanctuary. You zombied out. Man, how many of y'all can't wait to get home? Now you got to be kidding. You got to be kidding. You know some real adult talk here? I might be so happy that I taught this night. This might be my night clothes. I'm going to teach you how to live. If you listen. If you don't, I'm going to keep living. I can't wait till you catch on. other side of your suffering, you can't even calculate the other side of what you've been through. I can't wait till you look in a man's eyes and see yourself. Oh, you got something to live for, huh? I can't wait until your daughter say, Mommy, I want somebody like, ooh, God. Daddy, and it ain't the one who made her. I don't want you to have a doctorate in suffering or sadness. Oh, I wish I would have listened. Can I get another Ariel? That chick happy, y'all. Is Blythe a happy baby? Blythe is a happy baby because I have a happy mommy and a happy daddy in another country. Instead of visiting Nandi in Rwanda with some king that's going to find her, you stuck at Mega Saver with trying to put $5 in a gas tank in a car you can't even cut off. Everybody ain't laughing. Stuck with Mr. Nobody. You pull up at Mega Saver and there's his other girlfriend. It's real talk. You find out your baby and the other baby got the same birthday. All because you never had a song, never had a bubble bath, never just built your own choir, mass choir on the inside. Did not pray, came to church, but didn't praise God. Mm-hmm. Now you ain't got nothing. And when you turn 30, a tear. Even if you happy when you turn 30, a tear going to hit your face. Because you won't believe your 20s are over with. 40, you've been on earth. Time of testing, you ain't learned nothing. 50, you are half a century. 60, you are 10 away from the minimum. Next year, Lord willing, big year for me. I will have been out of high school 50 years. I can't wait to go to the reunion. I may break my brick phone. Kenny, I may truck my Phantom Coupe. And it used to be getting a rental car. I ain't driving it. That's too far. I trucked my Phantom Coupe for the event. The first shall be last. The last shall be first. Huh? Who am I talking to? You just a shower. Nah, I'm transporting my joy to the place that didn't remember me being this happy. Y'all play with me. I'm transporting my joy. The it dude in school, Jackson, who I found had all the bad clothes, all the pretty girl, he just fly. He didn't make it though. For some reason, baby facing him wouldn't let him join. And you know, Manchild, the deal, all them. Davion didn't know that Rafer Griffin and Reggie Griffin were my neighbors. When I took my tricycle and ran off the porch, concrete porch, tricycle with no brakes. Yeah, tricycles didn't have brakes. Their mother, top musicians, Rafer, Reggie, their mother jumped the fence. Those are my next door neighbors.
Okay. So, when your reunion, you're not even out of school yet, people come back and the story tells itself. Huh? Oh, no, the one I showed her, I showed a picture of the kid I went to school with. I said, we're the same age. He looked like my grandfather. He's dead. Today I was counting dead folk. Holiness, not going to church, has been very good to me. Huh? Holiness. And your success will extend my life. Come on, Grandma. Evan, with the love of his life, done wrote a book, bestseller. They done made a movie out of it. They done made a movie. He tells the whole story. Huh? Are you kidding? Simona's three kids standing up there accomplished, saying it wasn't until we went to Mom Mona's house. Olive on the podium. Thank you, Mama, for showing me how to live. Thank you for travel. Thank you for the passport. Thank you. I look forward to our vacation. Every head bowed. I'll just stop on a dime. There's a little boy that Rafi used to bring to church all the time. Rafi and the mother are good friends. And this little boy that sat in Grace Apostolic always had a sharp haircut and wore polo. I never seen this child with the same shirt on. Guess where he is today? In jail. Because she dressed him up on the outside, but did not dress him up on the inside. He is in jail right now. That says sharp, clean cut every day. Pray, KT. We got a whole new set of lambs. We got Wade anchoring the second. I got Wade in between the priests and the lambs on purpose. As he awaits the queen of his life. Everything I do on purpose. What would I give to walk Echo down that aisle? Y'all think I'm playing. I don't play. I'm a real serious cat. Pray, KT.
Precious Lord, Father, and Savior in heaven, Lord, we thank you. We thank you for a joyful word, Lord. Hallelujah. Word to remind us we got something to be glad about.
Yes.
David danced. David had joy.
Yes.
Because he did not lose what was lost before. We have not lost. We still have what we had last week.
Lord,
we should
have mercy.
Truly have joy, Father.
I still got my Elo. I still got my Cammy. I still got my CJ. Amen. I still got my Zoe. I didn't lose nothing on the 4th of July. Somebody in Highland Park can't say that. I didn't lose no members. Man, I'll be thinking myself happy. I don't know what trip y'all on. I'll be thinking myself happy. Amen.
So, Lord, we thank you most of all for a relationship with you. We thank you most of all for the Holy Ghost, because we know one of the superpowers is joy, Father. Hallelujah.
Sure is.
And we have to learn to take advantage of that while we still have the breath of life. Lord, we give you praise, honor, and glory with joy right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Oh,
amen.
God.
Huh? Look at my Trajan over there growing up. Look at her husband out there done dug a ditch. Man, come on now.